We're pleased to welcome in Mike Modano, 21 years between Dallas and Minnesota. That's pretty remarkable, Mo. Of course, you had that one last stop in Detroit. Congratulations to an amazing career. Tell us what you think about all this stuff with Radulov and where the Dallas Stars are at today.
Well, they're obviously an exciting team to watch. I mean, they have been for the last couple of years when they added Radulov and a few other key guys. But certainly that line is one of the top lines, obviously, in the league, and they're playing well. They're just kind of feeding off one another. They've all had great starts to the season, which certainly helps the confidence, and then you just kind of roll from there. But they've been fun to watch so far. Montgomery's done a great job. He's a young guy, enthusiastic, and seems like he's got the guys having some fun and enjoying what they're doing. And it's a whole new process for those guys, a new coach. So, but they seem to be catching on quick.
All right, Mike, let me get to the more serious questions here. Right? I'm home Friday night. There's no games. I'm sitting there with my 14-year-old son, and on the NHL Network, The Mighty Ducks comes on, and I have not seen that movie probably since it came out. And my son and I were watching it. We were enjoying it. And I remember you were in it. What do you remember about making that movie so long ago?
Well, I think it was the spring of 90 or 91, I think. And we went on strike, actually, that year during the, before the start of the playoffs. One of our many thought-out negotiation ploys through the union. But it didn't last very long, but it lasted long enough for them to bring us in and film that part with Basil McRae and I. So it was fun. I mean, meeting Emilio and all the kids, and we just kind of had a short little cameo. It took a few hours to shoot, but I've had more kids come up to me, ask me about Mighty Ducks than actually ask me about my hockey career.
Oh, that's amazing. Well, I mean, listen, the movie is an ultimate classic, and we air it on the network all the time. But then we saw an appearance in the National Football League yesterday, Adam Thielen with these cleats. Did you see these, and what did you think of these?
I saw them. I loved them. I didn't know, you know, Adam's a Minnesota kid and obviously has a little bit of history with hockey there. And but I saw the logo and I'm like, oh, this is perfect. So I kind of piggybacked on the Minnesota Vikings tweet there too about the shoes. But Adam's a great guy. He's having a great year. And I told him I love the shoes.
Mike, I look around the league on a little more serious note, and I see a lot of the great players like yourself, Joe Sakic, Steve Yzerman, up until recently, working in front offices for clubs. And I wonder when we're going to see you with the club. Obviously, 1,500 games in the league. You won a Stanley Cup. You won a World Cup. A lot of experience there. What are your thoughts on that long term?
I'm actually starting to get the bug a little, Brian, to get back into it and kind of get involved in some way, capacity of some sort. You know, busy with kids, but nonetheless, I think I've been away from it not long enough to kind of miss it a little bit. And you miss the camaraderie, you miss the chance of creating something and working with kids and possibly maybe working with some young guys. So that part I've always enjoyed, kind of helping kids get acclimated to the NHL, young kids growing up and coming through the ranks. So I hope so. I hope in the near future something's there, but, you know, I'm full-time dad, but I wouldn't, you know, turn that down for a second. I love it. The kids have been a lot of fun, but yeah, there's a little bit of part of me that would love to get back involved.
All right. Speaking of kids, it seems like in the shot there's a picture of one of your kids over your shoulder. I mean, just fill us in there. Is that a ghost? I mean, what's happening there?
I just was looking at that. I'm like, oh, that's Jack hanging. He made some project in school. I told him I'd hang it up somewhere, but I didn't really kind of plan this to be on the back of my left shoulder.
Oh, so, it's beautiful. We love it.
That's part of his arts and crafts project at school, but it wasn't meant to be part of the shot.
You know what, though? It's amazing because it's such a, like, proud dad moment. And now you have proof, right? Like, see, I got your assignment on display. You're holding up your end of the bargain. But listen, thanks. Sorry, go ahead.
No, I was just saying, we don't have an inch left on our refrigerator. We got pictures all over the place. So.
Good. I can only imagine. Well, listen, thanks for taking some time to chat with us. If you ever do end up in some front office somewhere, just promise us that you won't snub us if we ask you to come on the show.
That's right.
You guys will be the first to know.
All right. Yes. Mike Modano, a producer of NHL Now. Thank you for chatting.